In this screencast, we're going to work through an example that involves two reactions, one that produces a desired product and one that produces an undesired product. And we're going to look at how we would calculate the percent conversion of one of our reactants, in this case A, the yield of C, our desired product, a selectivity of C to D, or a selectivity of the desired to undesired, and also a percent excess of our other reactant, B. So in this problem, we have a reactor, and you see the two reactions, one A plus B goes to 2C, and the other A plus 2B goes to D. We're given information about each species in terms of the specific gravity of that species and the molecular weight. And we're told that out of the reactor, we have a specific composition, where we have 8 weight percent A, 35 weight percent B, 42 weight percent C, and 15 weight percent D. With any material balance problem, we would start with a schematic. Here, that's given to you. Second, we'd fill in information that we're looking for, again, given to us. But in this case, what we notice that we don't have is a basis. And typically what you see is that we would choose some kind of basis in our inlet stream. For instance, 100 moles per hour entering. But in this case, since we have an outlet composition and given to us in a weight percent, it makes more sense to pick a basis leaving and to do so on a mass basis. So here I'm going to choose 100 kilograms per hour. Now this will simplify our problem since now we have all the information necessary for our outlet stream. So at this point our only unknowns in the problem are our inlet composition or flow rates. So let's say that we're missing our flow of A and flow of B. Now I could write this as some kilograms per hour entering, but since we're working with reactions, the only way we're going to be able to do these balances is to work on a mole basis. So I'm going to say some unknown A. So the same goes for a flow rate of B into our reactor. So we have two unknowns. So let's write out our strategy on how we're going to solve this. First, as we just mentioned, we need to convert our outlet stream to moles. This will allow us to use the extended reaction method to do our material balances. Two, use extent of reaction method to solve for NA naught and NB naught. Then lastly, we can do what the problem states, which is to look at the percent conversion, the yield, the selectivity, and the percent excess. And we want to make sure that we don't stop at just calculating the flow rates and that we do answer this question and solve for these four things. So the first thing to do in our plan is to convert our outlet composition into a mole percent. So to do that, we can take each of these species and multiply it by our mass flow rate of 100 kilograms an hour to get each individual species mass flow rate. For instance, 8 weight percent of 100 kilograms is 8 kilograms per hour of A. We do this for each of the species, and we've now converted to mass flow rates. Now, if we take the mass of a species, so let's take a look at A, we take 8 kilograms per hour and divide this by the molecular weight of A, which is 24 kilograms per kilomole, we now get a value that is going to be kilomoles per hour. We get 0.33 kilomoles per hour. So we've converted our mass percentage now into a molar flow rate. So we could repeat this process for B, C, and D, and I'm going to plug that into our schematic. And we've now effectively taken care of our first step of converting the outlet to a molar flow rate. So our next part of the plan is to use the extent of reaction method to solve for our inlet flow rates. So I've written our first reaction and our second reaction here. Let's start with the general material balance where we have in minus out plus whatever we generate minus what we consume. This is going to be equal to what we accumulate. Now for a steady state process, which we're assuming that this is, we won't have any accumulation in the reactor. So this is going to be zero. So we're going to use this to write our balances for each of the four species. So let's start with A. If we take the form of out equals what comes in minus what's consumed plus what's generated. Then we could write NA, which is the flow rate leaving the reactor for A, as equal to the flow rate entering the reactor minus what's consumed. And so when we use the extended reaction method, we're going to write that what's consumed is 1 mole of A per reaction of A on a molar basis. So here we use the extended reaction 1 minus the extended reaction 2. Since for each reaction that occurs up here, A plus B goes to 2C, that produces 2 moles of C will consume 1 mole of A. For every second reaction that occurs on a molar basis, we'll also use 1 mole of A. So that's how we write this balance. So following that same logic for B, we write NB is equal to NB naught minus the extended reaction 1, since 1 mole is consumed for each 1 mole of reaction, minus 2 times the extended reaction 2. Since we're consuming 2 times the amount of B compared to A for each reaction that occurs to produce the undesired product D. So for C, molar flow rate of C out is going to be what's coming in, which is nothing, minus what's consumed, which again, C is not consumed in either reaction. So we just look at what's generated. So it's generated at 2 times each reaction 1. D follows the same logic as C. This case is just equal to the extended reaction 2. So now we have each of our material balances set up, and we know each of the flow rates leaving the reactor. So now I look at these four equations and I see 4 unknowns, which means we should be able to solve this. And as you can see, some of these equations become pretty straightforward. In this case, we know the extended reaction 2 must be 0.25 kilomoles an hour. So we could plug that into our other equations. We also see that we could solve for the extended reaction 1. In this case, it must be equal to 1 kilomole an hour. So we could plug that into our equations for A and B. This allows us to solve for the flow rate of A and the flow rate of B into the reactor. And you should get 1.58 kilomoles per hour for the flow rate of A into the reactor and 3.44 kilomoles per hour for the flow rate of B. So if we go back and look at our plan, we've now solved for our flow rate into the reactor. We can now look at the conversion yield, selectivity, and percent excess of B. To calculate the conversion of A, we look at the amount of A that came into the reactor and compare it to the amount of A that left. This is all over the original amount that came in. So if 100 moles entered and nothing came out, then we would expect this to be 100 over 100, and therefore a conversion of 1 or 100%. So when we take this ratio and multiply it by 100, we get 79% conversion of A. Now another thing that is of interest is to calculate the yield of our desired product, C. Now to calculate the yield of C, it's the theoretical amount of C that we could produce based on our limiting reagent, in this case A. So if we know that we have 1.58 kilomoles per hour of A, then we could produce 3.16 kilomoles per hour of C. That's if we had a perfect yield of 100%. So to calculate our actual yield, we take what came out of the reactor over our theoretical amount and multiply by 100 to get a percent. So in this case, what came out of the reactor was 2 kilomoles per hour. What we hoped to get out was 3.16 kilomoles per hour. So when we calculate this, we get a yield of C of 63%. The other thing to look at with two reactions is the selectivity of the desired product to the undesired product. So in this case, we look at the ratio of C produced to D produced. And all we're going to do is calculate how many moles of C came out compared to how many moles of D came out. And that will tell us that this reactor, under these conditions, produces 8 kilomoles of C per kilomole of D. And so that's our selectivity of C to D. The last thing we look at is the excess percent of B that's added to this reactor. So we take what's fed, we subtract out the amount that we would need for theoretical yield, and we divide by how much is needed. So we had 3.44 kilomoles per hour enter our reactor. We only needed 1.58 kilomoles per hour based on how much A entered the reactor. So when we take this and divide it by 1.58 and multiply this whole thing by 100, we get 118% excess of B fed to the system. These are the four answers we would box. Hopefully that gives you an idea of working with two reactions and doing our material balances.